back.
Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy 1, Mod of Balance. Now that we're done... Okay, now. We need to go hit the case cave. Thank you. Helheim. And then head off to the next place to ask him. Let's head back to Milmond and see what spells we pick from there.
I think I'll just buy items in Provoca. Next battle, maybe, yeah, probably more giants.
Come here as soon as we have the canoe.
And again, no ice.
However, because one of the things the mod of balance does is remove class changes. And the class change was really the only reason to come here early. So,
yeah.
The other thing the mod does is it makes magic a lot more variable. spells can vary up to 50% either way from their base damage. So they can hit really hard or not very hard. Okay.
Nice shield block.
That cave there is another one of the optional dungeons. Here we are, the Cavern of Ice. And it's playing the music from the Twin's Cave. Don't petrify any more party members. The important thing is to make them dead. No! There's no defend options, so... Now we'll finish the fight. I just wanted to make sure that... I got rid of... petrification. These things haven't really been a threat since the Earth Cave. No, the Marsh Cave. And we're still fighting. Thank you.
okay, you can stop that. Stop it, seriously. Oh, you're kidding me. Fucking god, I just... I should have been a fine battle to fight, except that they just kept targeting Hero over and over and over. Of course, you heal. Now you heal faster, you fuckers. Oh, fuck you. Shitting me.
Piscodemons prep their friend to help them. Our friend needs to be dead. Avoid stepping on those cracks.
Worth the trouble, kind of.
Should be good.
I didn't know they could their physics put to sleep too. Okay. Thank you.
stepping on these cracks.
Oh, come on, that's too soon. Seems a lot weaker than the ice brand. I hate it when she uses her cure spell too early.
Good, this one I can probably handle.
Now we have these. Works exactly the same as the lava, I think.
Or not? Ah!
That does not look pleasant. I'm glad they both didn't decide to do that. That would have sucked.
Can you even handle two of them?
Thank you. I not give one of them Null Frost?
Oh, fuck's sake.
You have Null Frost. Okay. No. Okay.
Okay, that's the exact same outcome. Same damage, the same.
This is not looking good. Now, fights with dragons at this point in the game tend to be triggered by stepping on certain tiles. That one's so much better. Thank you. powerful than the flame sword, but no extra things. Yeah. That is not better. No new spells for us. Back on this floor. Sure, you're still. I'm not actually sure if Masters ever hit level 3 magic now, thinking about it. They probably do it somewhere. Sleeping bag, ice shield. We can't use the ice shield. You can, you're kidding it. Okay. As soon as we step in front of this. Get to fight what's essentially the boss area. So I'm going to Get for being used to tackling us so much earlier in this fight. And we got the Levy Stone. Yeah, no, out of this dungeon. And that was the Cavern of Ice. Next time, we get to go see what the Levy Stone does. It'll be worth it. See you guys then.
So disappointing.
Hello friends, my name is MC Jamalam and Hello friends, my name is McJamalam and today boy do I have a
Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy 1 Mod of Balance. We finished the Cavern of Ice last time, and now we have to go take the Levy Stone, it's a magical levitating rock, and go figure out what to do with it. And here we are. This is the desert, just south of the Crescent Lake. And apparently levitating stones really mess up deserts. You didn't get this awesome cutscene in the original, unfortunately. But yeah, here it is. The very first airship in a Final Fantasy game. Didn't have the Mode 7 effects either. Now that we have this though, traveling around is significantly easier. Here's where we got our ship, our regular ship. What I'm looking for is trigger this one. I think. I'm just gonna check the map. No, it's this one. I don't think I can land the airship here. Close the second on the airship. It's way down here. And I don't even know. Actually, since we have the airship, let's see. Which island was it? I don't remember. Just have to try them all. That one had money. Try either. Gold needle. I have the spine.
Jeez, that's a lot of HP.
Oh, can't land here. This is one of the optional dungeons, bonus dungeons. This is when we unlock when we lift the fire crystal.
If one has that many HP, I can't.
Ooh, elixir.
Stunned.
Now, in the unmodded Final Fantasy 1, we would have done the trials by now. In fact, we probably would have. Oh, this must be where. Let's say we're talking about this here. And I don't think I can land my ship anywhere here. So all right. Before we head to the some nice spells there, but
I
towards stopping Kitty. Well, not that they're actually getting. Saber and Bulldog are good. Saber would not be good for him, though, because it can only be cast on that. He'd only be able to cast it on him. Well, that is useful. At the very least, I'm giving
it's not my fault.
The people who have the ability to get life. Yeah, I don't really need any of those right now. Anyway, now that that little trick is done, what's the nearest place I can park my airship here? All right. That looks like we're ready. Technically, you can do this as soon as you get the crown. However, because you can't really get the main reward until you have the airship, most people don't bother with it until then.
We only get 101 gold. We got a lot of experience. Same amount of experience as normal. Which HP does the fucker have?
I don't have a map.
1650. Shit. I only get so far 1 gold. Screw you, game. I'm gonna go back and heal already. I can drop a power plus, but I don't know the rate.
Ooh, there's a door. Okay. Ooh, goblets. I remember it. Cast thunder when used. absolutely amazing in the original game. But the original game had a vastly different magic system than this does. The Dawn of Souls remake changed the magic system to be more in line with the later Final Fantasy games. In the first and third Final Fantasy game, you don't have regular MP. Let's keep going. We have access to a lot of teleports here. But you don't have regular MP. Every spell level has its own MP, and it wasn't very much. So, and there was no real way to restore it outside of staying at the end.
How's this?
And you didn't have any fancy high potions or anything. You have regular potions. So you were very restricted on the amount of restoration you had access to. So things like the gauntlets, which lets you cast spells without spending what limited magic you had. Let's try this one.
I'm gonna be back. I'm gonna make some tea because I need to pick up the energy boost. And I need to take just a little bit of a break. That Allosaurus was no
way. Anyway. Anything that lets you cast spells without using up what little MP you had was imperative. Darn it. Okay. Yeah. Okay. And this is the big room where I have a whole bunch of choices. These things. I haven't seen them before. Oh, that was not good. Okay. Slow isn't as bad as okay. These things are amazingly resilient. Yeah. And everyone was alive at the end of that battle, too, so.
Actually, I'll use my proceeds to go buy a shield, a buckler in,
Darn it.
Oh. I have over 2,000, right? Yeah.
Very
easy. Go buy a shield and a buckler for
him.
Because my lead guy needs more defense. He's taking too many hits. Too much damage.
I will say that it is kind of weird playing Final Fantasy 1 and 2 Dawn of Souls. After playing one of the earlier versions of the game.
I need to buy another new keyboard. Okay. This one was cheap and it's not really good.
How about some instant death immunity? It's always nice to not have to worry about being. Oh no! The one person who. Okay, missed.
Yeah, he actually, yeah, he can use an iron shield. So my tank, my two guys in front will get some more defense.
Ultimately, it wasn't necessary. But...
Oh, one more defense point. He gets more.
Okay. Minotaur zombie is significantly less scary than dragon zombie.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh yeah, feathered caps. I need feathered caps for my guys. For, what can this archmage use? Okay, not say everyone should be able to use a buckler in the party. If anyone, the archmage shouldn't be able to. And why can't the archmage use a feathered cap? That doesn't make sense.
Okay. I must be running out of options.
Oh, you got a Viking axe drop. Nice.
I'm really wishing I just pulled up a map of this place.
I don't think anyone can use it in my party. I don't think anyone in my party can use axes, so if one had dropped for me, I would have sold it for the money.
Come on.
That saber is getting some use.
There we go, Blizzard. No die.
Ah.
Three levels. Looks like Wolf was left behind. Sorry, Wolf. Okay. And then level 4, which probably means Fiolara. Yeah, I think he can make a level, so. Not a bad spell to know. Yes! Third floor. No more stupid teleporting things. just a bunch of really annoying things. Oh, okay, thank you. Please miss, please miss. Okay. It's Wolf's turn. Oh, free stuff. Radiates divine energy. Actually, can you equip that?
I'll be right back.
Yeah. And they're all dead. Now, if I remember right, mummies can paralyze you. Which isn't as fun, but it's not as bad as being petrified. Took a bit of beating. Cat claws, ice friend, and a protect ring. It's good. In fact, you know what? Yeah. Now we have three characters with resistance to instant death. I'm not sure if it's immunity in this game. Here's our prize, the rat's tail. and attack the corn devils. Oh, come on. I was one step away. Just...
Yay, an ice shield drop. Ooh. I'll keep the iron shield in case... Oh, they dropped three of them?
Then,
we'll talk about
with this
place. Oh, wow.
Alright. The yellow dot is the regular ship and the red dot down there.
Wow, that just saved me money.
Which I'm gonna go get now. So,
I hope it doesn't make me weaker to, No, that's bad. Bad Minotaur zombie. Brains asleep. Ah!
Okay. Now, normally this is taking the rat tail to Bahamut. Get you a class change. Of course, the mod changes so you just get access to a whole bunch of advanced classes at the beginning. So instead, and we look exactly the same. But we got everyone got 50 more hit points than they had before. So definitely worth doing, especially for Korn, if it's pathetically low hit points. Negligible defenses. It's no longer so vital to do that quest so early. Anyway, that's it for this time. See you guys next time when we look at some of the other things we can do with our new airship. See ya. Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy 1 Modded Balance. Today, we are going... here. After I reset up and...
Fuck you, Minotaur Zombie.
Now, the idea behind this war is that you're stuck wandering through what is essentially an endless desert. The exit for the next war is pointed to by the formations of trees. So if we follow over trees plant, we should get to the exit. There are also a few treasures that you can find, but none of them are particularly worth wandering through an endless desert trying to find. I think these guys need to go away. That'll do it. Okay. Everything you can fight here can be relatively minor, except for a single enemy that's ever spawned here in the desert. I don't think that's it. Okay, that was a lot of damage. Oh yeah, he's poisoned too. Should take care of that. Of course, the arrows wouldn't achieve direct attack.
Didn't earn much money there, except for the ice shields that might sell for a lot. But I need two of them equipped.
One tree.
So I have enough room to buy two feather caps, so I'll go do that.
And the stairs down. Rest of the floor is much less painful. This being the first bonus engine, it's the shortest.
Only 10 floors total. I'll see if the feathered cap has any special defenses. Special.
Oh, yeah.
Just defense evasion.
Potion. Speed drink.
Those were enemies in Final Fantasy V. Six defense, I guess we toned it down a little. Gives good evade, 12 evasion. That's gonna help. Woo, 5,000. Cha-ching. I'll go buy. So it's worth 10,000. I'll go buy two tempers. Oh, I have no frost. Just try to recast it now.
This one's fun.
Let's go try to clear. Can't believe three shields. That's perfect. Two for my guys and one to sell for the money I need for tempers. The Marsh Cave should be fairly easy with should serve my MP though. Any groups I can kill physically do so. Only all my MP. I should have bought some tents. I'll even at least sleeping bags to get healing.
Silver apple. Nice.
If all goes well, I'd like to finish off the Marsh Cave today and Astos and get the Magical Robes to sell for money. Actually, I might equip the Magical Robe I get from him on my guy, because he's the only guy who can be paralyzed.
not particularly threatening. I don't think there's any reason to go up there.
I'm gonna alternate Dia and Kane in here.
That doesn't help. I'm gonna go this way. I don't feel particularly threatened by these guys.
Poison, fuck you.
I see a chest up there. This item is probably very much overkill for these enemies.
After the first, after I go to the top floor, I'll come back and use a tent to
know when I bought all of this, you know, there's no way I could cure conditioning antidotes. I was very wrong.
Yes. Slow kind of wrecks our physical characters. Which makes it kind of a pain that they're the ones who are always affected by it.
I'm surprised I made it through that fight without anybody getting poisoned. Oh. That's right. The Venom Dagger isn't an upgrade now. Shit. Come on, that.
McGinnion, I'm getting poisoned.
Speed plus.
You could have Corey here apparently immune to it. The only piece of equipment they have in common is a detector ring. And well, it's a detector ring and piece of the slow. So yeah, I don't know what's... Oh, that.
Ah.
The invasion that he just got. Going to be fantastic.
So no one can use the Greyhound? That sucks.
Rolling Cloak is one of the few pieces of equipment that casters get to equip their shield slot. Thank you.
fast as my full knife they have. More accuracy. Might as well.
That's better than just addicting to it. Never use your super thing. many bites.
Two of them.
And here we have the end of the dungeon. Four rooms each of us. This one's surface. Couldn't hurt. It's the only way I can go. The door behind me would have been locked if I tried it. You can only fight one boss per trip. Can anyone actually use the Thief's Glove? No. Look at that. It's not bad, but I think I'd rather stick with the death resistance. But yeah, that was the... That was the first bonus dungeon. The Earth Gift Shrine. And... Next time. Let's see what the other bosses can do. See you guys. Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy 1 Modded Battle Bounce.
I feel proud of myself for having save states. You can save in the Earth side, so if you have to, you can serve us again. If you can. The next fight, you mean? Because you already fought Cerberus. Glitch for me. First cool time I've had a glitch. Glitch display.
Yeah, Earthquake is a good spell. It's a not fun spell, but hits your entire party, bypasses his inceptive conditions, at least for the, check those.
That sucks.
Well, and
Chandra has three times attack.
Why? That's not what I meant to do.
I don't know if he's inspired. Check. There is a limit in this to how many times you can temper and actually do any good.
Wow. Oh, lots of items. Nice deal. So my prison top slot's got the worst chest to resist from.
Okay.
That sucks.
Okay, so here I go. Thank you. very rich at PvP.
What did he do? Why are the Earthgift Shard bosses so fucking hard?
Okay, so here I go.
You went from full to dead? Blaze. What?
That, however, is very rich.
I've earned good money.
You never knew what you were.
Defensive but heavy.
So many bites. And here we have the end of the dungeon. Four rooms each with boss. This one's surface. Couldn't hurt. Fire.
She's protected now.
Okay.
was Blizzard, I think. It wasn't Blizzard.
No idea how much how many hit points. No idea how many hit points that has.
Yeah, I think that's bizarre about this. Has the...
There we go.
So Cerberus,
hello, and welcome back. Let's play Final Fantasy 1.
Forgot to use the end.
Today, I'm going to be doing another bonus boss in the Earth of the Shrine.
First fight is against a kid.
Yeah, Earthquake is a fun spell. It's a not fun spell that hits your entire party, bypasses instant death resistance, at least for the check rings, if I pass those. Oh, and you know Flare. That hurt even more.
Mm-hmm.
think the best protection is crossbow. You know. I'd rather be safe. I'd rather try it, you know. So. Two-headed dragon. I don't know if he uses fire, but I'm gonna play it safe this time. Checked up. You will help the dead.
That was bullshit. I can't believe darkness makes him weak too.
Right.
Every fucking status sucks.
Try to beat him normally first.
Where are they? Not up here.
Okay, he just... I know
And he's got a nasty spell. Oh, there we go. He's muted.
Sweet!
Oh, and he's sleep, too.
Surprisingly effective blade.
What? Ice storm.
It's not how it's so far down on this way, apparently. Well, it's not gonna matter because we still have one more fight.
Try putting you back to sleep.
Okay. Here it is. Last boss.
No magical robe drop. That's okay.
Ottoman.
I'll do one sick.
There is Terra and
Death. Damn it, I don't want to open. I know the drop rate for the bosses is much better than in the original, so it might only take a few tries to get it.
Okay, so Kirag is...
Okay, I can handle that. Without that null frost.
That, however, was very much a painful experience.
Dark Elf fight from the Assault Run.
And this one, I'm probably going to end up having to try over again.
Oh, he eats him asleep, me. Jerk. Thank you. dropped.
Actually.
Clary. Bards. I'm keeping the Bard's tunic forever because it could come in handy.
Okay.
I think I'll end my recording now.